That's great that you're close by.
Okay, I think maybe we've reached the quorum and we should start. So thank you all very much for taking the time to come over for this workshop on mathematics, morphogenesis, morphometrics. I know there are some people over here who may not be familiar with the fact that there are two anniversaries, and so it's for those and to remind others. The first is the 50th year anniversary of a set of volumes which was edited by developmental biologist Conrad Waddington between the years 1966 and 1968. They're still available, I think, at old bookstores, titled Towards a Theoretical Biology. And in this, Waddington says no conceptualization of a living system is adequate unless it includes at least four importantly different timescales, those of metabolism, development, heredity, and evolution. And so Waddington was, of course, very much a developmental biologist, but also a very broad thinker. And the focus of this meeting is very much on aspects of development, but as you will see from the speakers, talk titles, and what you're going to hear, they, of course, connect across scales. The other anniversary, perhaps even more famous, last year was the 100th anniversary of Growth and Form by Darcy Thompson, a biologist, a philologist, a mathematician, and author of On Growth and Form. And in the preface to what he himself called the preface and an exhortation for people to start thinking about biology mathematically, he said, an organism is so complex a thing and growth so complex a phenomena that for growth to be uniform and constant is unlikely and unusual. Rates vary, proportions change, the whole configuration of the body. So essentially, in a nutshell, telling us how form arises, and raising the question which is the focus of this workshop. There are two, one this week and another one in December. I'll tell you about the second one after I tell you about where you're all and why you're all here. Darcy Thompson started out by saying if you want to basically describe form, you have to use mathematics. He was not the first one, although the last chapter of his book is perhaps the most famous one, and we're going to hear directly about that, I think, from Anuj and Eric and others. Alfred Durer famously has this woodcut where he shows essentially how you can have affine transformations, shape transformations of a face from one to the other. The advantage of that, of course, is that it's beautiful, elegant mathematically. The disadvantage is perhaps it's not physical. So that's understanding shape. The second approach, which Darcy Thompson also talked about, didn't have a whole lot to say, is the physical approach, asking about how shape might arise from biophysical principles. The advantage of that is that you're doing close to physical law. The difficulty is, of course, that we have potentially a large, very large number of parameters which we may not have access to. So our goal, from the perspective of these workshops, the first one this week and the next one in December, is one which I think everybody over here would agree are very nice, very important, and I think now is a good time to address some of these questions. How do we describe and compare shape in biology? How do we predict and control shape? And you can approach this from a pair of different approaches in biology, from a developmental perspective, from an evolutionary perspective, and bringing everybody over here together, all of you over here, from also a mathematical and a physical perspective. And I'm not going to speak about this slide except to point out that there are many, many different scales on which many people over here and elsewhere have thought about growth and form, going from the molecule all the way to physiology and function. How can we essentially do this? Is this an opportune time? We think so. That's why we have the workshop, also coincides with the wonderful set of anniversaries. There are two quotes which I love. I think almost everybody over here is familiar with them. Statistician George Box said famously, all models are wrong, some are useful. I like even better one that Paul Ginsberg told me, all models are right, most are useless. And we hope to be somewhere in between these two, closer to the top, just before. Okay, so I'm not going to spend any time beyond this introducing what's going to happen, but Anuj, Olivier, who are my co-conspirators, wanted and said they'd be willing to essentially really put together something which brings the mathematicians, the biologists of all ilks, both in mathematics and biology together. And so with that perspective, we have 3 1.5-hour tutorials, 2 today and 1 tomorrow, by Anuj, Sayan Mukherjee, and David Gu, who I don't see yet, but hopefully will appear sometime soon. And from the biology perspective, the goal is really to have people all of you over here from very different scales, from cells all the way to tissues and organs, from an evolutionary point of view, and also a developmental point of view. And also there are mathematicians and statisticians who are going to tell us about a bunch of different specific examples. So that's the plan, to basically bring everybody together. As people have already noticed, our talks are fairly relaxed schedule, so we have 45 minutes. Please spend 15 minutes at least to put in your question in perspective, because of the broad backgrounds that people have come from. Please leave enough time for questions. So there's plenty of time over the course of this workshop. Lunch will be upstairs, so we can mingle here. Breakfast is always outside at 8:30 every morning. Dinner today is either at 6 or 6:30, we're still not sure. It's about a half hour walk from here, depending on the weather. You may want to walk or you may want to take the tea. Restroom around the corner. anything else that I need to ask or confirm? 2 key pieces of information. Wi-Fi, for those of you from outside Harvard, you should be able to log in without any issues if you just use the Harvard Guest website. A lot of people have come from afar. Thank you very much for doing so. For reimbursements, please talk to Sarah LeBoeuf, who we've been corresponding with already. She's in room 103. Arnab.
Yeah, don't see Harvard guest on what?
Just Harvard University.
Just Harvard University. And log in as guest. Sorry. Okay.
Or EduRoam.
Or EduRoam. Yes, yes. If you are used to EduRoam, it'll automatically do it. You don't have to worry about it at all. Anything else that I should say, Olivier, Anuj? As I said, there's plenty of time for informal discussions. I hope that we will have a lot of them. The meeting closes at lunch on Wednesday. Some of you are going to be here for longer. If you need space, if you want recommendations for other things to do, if you don't know the Boston Harvard area, I'll be happy to tell you about things. And we have a few postdocs around who are also going to be very happy, I'm sure, to essentially check them around. Okay, if not, I'm just going to hand it over to Anuj, and he's going to start with the tutorial.
Thank you.